Geeky Minecrafter here. If you're just joining us for the first time, kick your feet up, get your diamond pickaxe out. We're going to do a little bit of mining today. Before we get started, though, I wanted to give you a quick tour around the base, show you what we've got going on here. This is a new world for me. If you've been watching my Let's Play series, you might not recognize a lot of what's going on out here. I did come into a new world. I did it on the server. And I have built some initial resources. We have our potato farm here and here. We do have some wheat and corn growing in here. And as you can see, I've been growing it for a while. I am playing with a friend. He sleeps, you know, he comes in when he's got time and plays with me. He's helped me build a few things. We do have some resources that we've been accumulating. As you can see here, I've got some serious obsidian. I do want to build an XP farm, and that is going to take just a whole bunch of obsidian. So I'm going to pull some of this volume down. There's just no reason for it to be this loud. Now, if you can't hear it, let me know in the comments over there. Feel free to let me know when... you know, when you have a question or whatever. I am monitoring the chat room. So it looks like nobody's online. I'm going to stop talking. You know, I'll save it for the recording. Basically, I'm going to go do some mining and see where that leads us here. Welcome if you're just joining us. If you have a question, feel free to ask it in the chat. I am monitoring. This is the Geeky Minecrafter, and I am doing both a Let's Play series on YouTube and a live stream of some mining down here. Let me make sure I got everything put up that I don't need. And we will get started here. So basically, this is my mine. I'm at level 6 right now. I do have 2 levels to it, here and here. I am cutting some slits back in. Now, the slits are down below. They go back about 250, 300 blocks. I haven't been doing the same thing up here. Now, my teammate, my partner, has been helping me mine. Pull out some resources and take them and put them in the sorter room. He's been cutting slits over here, and as you can see, we have quite a ways. Here, let's... we getting started here. Good grief. I need some cobblestone. I need to get started so I can block these off. I don't like to leave these open, especially if they open up to caverns down there, because it allows, you know, the baddies to get into my mine and be working along, and next thing you know, you got a zombie breathing down your neck. So let me grab a couple of these just because. And block these off. Like I said, I really don't like them being open. Where were we? Here we go. So we've been mining in here for a while. We've pulled out a truckload of diamonds and ore. There we go. I've got some lava behind there that flares up from time to time. Since you're just joining us, I'll run you up here and show you the base. And I need to grab a couple of things, make sure I've got what I need downstairs. That's going to include some a new pick. So I think I've crafted one. I don't have enough levels to enchant it yet, which is one of the reasons I'm getting ready to go down here and start mining. Oh, hello. Yeah, well, fair warning, my keyboard skills are not the best. I wander around, run into walls, fall on my face. You know, it's big, big fun. So this is my sorter room. I'm pulling out resources as I accumulate them. I do need, and see, I have a little glitch happening here. Oh, it just did it. That's gonna stay like this until I leave and come back. I don't know what's going on. My display adapter has been giving me a little bit of grief. It's been causing my Java to crash from time to time. Yeah, this isn't gonna work. Okay, so if you can hear me, be patient. I'm going to leave Minecraft, be right back. Of course, underneath that I have the default version. So it does take a little while for it to load. Well, there we go, we're back. Okay. So I'm gonna grab this extra pick and head down to the mine. Start cutting some slits. This today is just a live mining stream. Oh, it looks like it says I'm offline. One second. Getting things done. It's not as easy as some of those people make it look. False Symmetry, for example, she makes it look like child's play. Not saying that, you know, well, I don't want her to take that the wrong way. You just make it look easy. So let's go right in here and make sure I have no creepy crawlies. Okay, so I've been working on this end of the mine. Jim's been working on the other end of the mine. So I'm just going to start right here. There's no reason I can't just start right here. Now, when I mine, I go three up. I know a lot of people talk about just going two. But I am, you know, mathematically, I want the greatest volume to be captured as possible. Okay, looks like, oh, did I not make torches before coming in here? Good grief, you know, I say I'm a geek, and you'd think I'd be better organized. I do like to, now that I have some cobblestone in my inventory here, I do like to block this off so that I'm in here alone. It looks like, there we go. I don't like them dropping in on me. Again, I'm a girl. I'm scared. I don't want those creepy crawlies dropping in on me. So I've been pulling out quite a few diamonds, quite a bit of iron. In fact, in my sorter room, I think I've got three or four double stacks of iron. And although that's great, it's not the kind of iron that you really, you know, you really need for the kind of building that I do. I do a lot of redstone, a lot of automation, and that means... You know, I need a lot of iron. So one thing I did do was created a iron golem farm. I did get that going, and it is producing. As a matter of fact, you know, let me know in the comments over here if you want to see the iron golem farm, see what I did. I know I said it was a live streaming, live mining, but you know, I'm here for you guys. If you want to see the golem. Oh, I'm in a different mine. Well, bloody hell. Okay. You believe that? Let's see. Ow. On my face. Okay, I do have a couple of mines going down here. Let me see if I can't do this so when I come back to this later, I know what the heck's going on. There we go. Did you notice I fell on my face? I am not the most graceful thing. If you were expecting grace, I'm sorry to disappoint. Look at this. I haven't come across anything but redstone. That's just, you know, this mine has been really productive. Oh, here we go. I spoke too soon. Now I am, I'm a Virgo, I'm anal retentive, I do like things to be clean and neat. So when I've done like this, when I've pulled it all out, I will fill it all back in. That serves two purposes. It lets me know where I've mined without leaving places for monsters to spawn. Oop, good grief. And keeps it nice and tight down here. And I didn't miss one, did I? Oh, I did right here. There we go. Again, anal retentive, what can I tell you? Now, when I hear lava, I don't know about you, but I like to go in a couple on the, you know, on the center one, dig this one out so that way the lava can't flow back on me. Now, right now, I'm not hearing any lava sounds, so I'm not worried about it, but, you know, you got to slow down and do it the right way when you're hearing that lava. I do have a stone pickaxe when I need to slow down and work around lava. This right now is my efficiency 3. I'm going to work with it until it gets down there pretty close to done. Then I'm going to save it and walk it back down, or upstairs rather, and marry it with another efficiency 3 and see if I can't get an efficiency 4 out of that. But I definitely need some levels to enchant with. I spent them all, did a bunch of enchanting earlier, did some mining, got a whole bunch of iron and stuff like that that I needed to put the hoppers together and build the iron golem farm. So if you could take a moment to put in the chat, give me your name, let me know how long you've been playing Minecraft. Oh, you don't want to chat? Well, that's okay. I don't chat in other streams very often either. Of course, most of the people I watch have a bunch of people in there, and I am a new Twitch channel, so, you know, don't have a whole lot of followers yet. I do intend to play a little bit every day. I don't know if daily or, you know, 2 or 3 times a week is the better way to handle this. In fact, if you have any advice on what you'd be wanting to watch, I'm available to that. Let me know in the chat, and I'll see if I can accommodate that. I'm just not finding anything. Okay, I have a cross channel cut down here, still a ways away. I like to be organized in how I mine. So the front channel is 3 across that way, you know, 3 blocks wide, and each one of these slits are one block wide. At the back end of this, and about 250, 300 blocks down, I have a 2 block wide slit. My torches always go on the right hand side when I'm moving away from the exit, and they go on the left hand side, obviously, when I'm going towards the exit. This allows me to just look down a hall and know which direction is back to base. So, you know, if the torches are on the left, that's back towards base. If I encounter a cross channel and it's 2 wide, I know I'm at the back end of the mine. If it's 3 wide, I know I'm at the front end of the mine. And, you know, it might sound like, you know, why would you need to know that? But, you know, my mines get quite large. You know, you spend a lot of time down here pulling resources out. You need to know where you are. Now, that's a little bit high, but it's right here over a torch. So I'm not going to worry about the ceiling right there. Just, oh, good grief. Just do these side pieces here. Okay, so I'm watching the chat. You're not saying anything. I would ask you who your favorite Twitch channel is, and what makes them your favorite. So, you know, if you could take a moment, put it in the chat window for me, that'd be great. I really would like your feedback. Like I said, I'm a new Twitch channel, which means, you know, I've got a lot of room to grow. I've got a lot of things I need to know how to do, and that means working with you guys, and because you're what the channel is all about. I mean, I could play Minecraft all day long. I don't have to stream it. I stream it because several people told me, you know, in my Let's Play series that they'd like to see me doing this live. So I'm trying to accommodate. But I'm going to play whether you guys are watching or not. So the channel is, you know, is definitely optional. Looks like I'm going to need some more torches here. Okay, well, since I'm at the, I'm almost there. Okay, let's go, I just want to go to like 520. Then we'll turn around and head back. I'll show you the Iron Golem farm. Do a little organizing. Get ready for the next run. I normally come down here with enough picks and enough food to... Uh-oh. Yeah. Where's that other one? Well, I don't like these guys. Oh, that's gonna be one too. Come on. What are these guys doing down here? Okay. Wow. Encountering lava. Not my favorite thing. So I guess... Yeah, I think I'm going to call it here. We're going to head back and offload what we've got. Oops, sorry about that. Technical difficulties. Well, that's the direction I was going. Oh, never mind. So, I don't know if you heard what I said before. I'm gonna head back to the entrance, offload what I've got, start some iron smelting, and then I'll show you the Iron Golem farm. Yeah, if you're putting links in the chat, don't bother. I've got it where it's gonna delete them. I may be a new streamer, but I know enough to know, you know, not to leave that open. Okay, let's cut this, put some more in here, and head up, go see the Iron Golem farm. I do have several caverns right around here. You'll see these cutouts on the sidewall. In fact, this one, fairly good size one. They spawn in here, drop in. But right now they can't get up to me this way, so I'm not too worried about that one. Okay. Okay, that's the Iron Golem farm. It's three levels. It has quite a few doors in it. It has quite a few villagers in it. The village is about 300 blocks that way. Getting them over here was a bit of a challenge. I still have some of my scaffolding up because I've got a couple of problems that I'm working on. But right now, this is what it delivers. When I came in here just a few minutes ago, there was, it looked like this. I like to leave, you know, one row, all the way across. So I've pulled an extra 29 gold and 7 poppies out just since I've been streaming. So it's a pretty effective farm. And because it's inside my spawn chunk, and you know that because, here, let me show you. One of the first things I did when I spawned into this world was go through and mark my spawn boundaries. Okay, so all of this represents the spawn chunk all the way around. So everything inside this boundary will be working no matter what I'm doing. If I'm in the Nether, if I'm off over there exploring, if I'm over there trading with the villagers, this will still be working, which means my iron farm will be producing iron as long as I'm in game. Now, been breeding me some villagers. I've got about this many in each one of these pods. And there are 4 pods, obviously. Let me get down here. I don't do really well on ladders. Can you tell? I frequently feel like I'm going to fall on my face. Okay, so I have cleared a path over here. This was just chock full of trees. I have been cutting them down, so I have a clear run. Now, I spawned into a swamp biome, and I've got a lot of slimes that come in at night, and I've got a few witches that pop in. As a matter of fact, there's a witch's hut like 30 blocks that way. So I'm planning an XP farm stationed around that witch hut that should let me get a whole bunch of fun drops. Now, this is my automated chicken cooker. It's got, let's see, it's got about, I don't know, 60-ish chickens in there. Lava in here. They're all set up on hoppers and dispensers. So, as you can hear, the dispenser is firing the eggs create the chickens. The chickens, when they grow up, hit the lava, they become cooked chicken. Again, I like automation, I mentioned that. So as you can see, okay, just again, since I've been here, that's what it looked like when I got here. So I've pulled 12 chicken, 32 feathers out. Now, the chicken cooker will speed up or slow down depending on a lot of factors, but it will continue to cook as long as I'm in world, which again gives me an unlimited food source. Now, I did cut a channel over here because, you know, I was having to run out and get chicken and having to cross the area there where they were all running around trying to kill me. So this is my input chest. This leads down into that sorting room I just showed you. So everything that I collect goes down into the sorter so that I can pull it out as I need it. Now I am enchanting. That stuff's down here. Oh, good grief. Come on. And then I do have a mob farm if you're interested in seeing it. I'll go ahead and put that in. Okay, here's my hub. This connects all my Nether portals. Right now I only have, I think it's just 3. This is my mob farm. So basically, check this out. Each one of those white layers represent a level where mobs can spawn. Inside there it's dark, and each one of these dark spots is a water dispenser. And over here, We've got a mechanical room that has a piston timer and a clock, and it basically fires the water dispensers every so often. Water flows out, washes the mobs down, they hit the splat pad and they die. I have water that flows on a different timer that flows all of the drops that I'm collecting from the mobs that hit this down into a hopper chain located right where the border of the lava and the water are. So basically, the mobs can survive if they fall while the water's flowing. So I have lava at the other end to kill them and cause them to drop their stuff. Now, I do lose some of the drops for each one of those. So one of the things I've done is try to speed up this so that it flows down, washes all the drops, and then fairly quickly diminishes so that the next time this does a drop, the water shouldn't be there. It does look like it's taking a little bit longer. I maybe need to slow that clock down just a bit more. Yeah, see, just like 3 seconds should have done it. Now, let me go down there and show you, and I wanted to pick up a few things. My next project involves quite a few dispensers, so I need some more string. I mean, I have some, but I don't have a whole bunch. Let's see. Now, please don't laugh if I fall on my face. This is no fun. Okay, this is the first mechanical room. And again, this controls the clock that controls the water that dispenses or that knocks the mobs down. Okay? Oh, it looks like I have a witch in there. Let me come up here and look. I'll show you. So you see the drops out there. The water flows down, washes them down into that channel, and they hit the hopper chain down below. Yep. It gets kind of loud. Okay, this is just my workroom and sorter. And as you can see, I've got quite a bit of string happening in here. I also need some more arrows. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Okay, so these are just some of the drops that are coming in, and I love that I occasionally get the random iron, mostly from zombies that spawn in carrying that stuff. As you can see, I've killed quite a few zombies. I do need to bring a bucket of lava up here and create an incinerator so I can get rid of that stuff. There's no reason for that. I have a maintenance access panel out there that heads over to that side, goes up to that clock, although we don't need to see that today, right? Okay, so I'm going to head back to the portal so I can head back home, take my booty, my string, my arrows. So this was a pretty good investment. It took quite a while to make it. I think I probably worked on it 3 or 4 days. Not Minecraft days, I mean 3 or 4 actual days. Had a few design issues, a couple of problems I had to resolve. But all in all, I'm pleased with the way it turned out. Now, it's not exactly like the one that I modeled it after. I've had to make some adjustments based on the resources that I had at the time I built it. Didn't have a whole lot of iron, for example. So the splat pad, I couldn't make, you know, 9 wide and, I don't know what it was, 45 long, because I didn't have enough, hoppers, didn't have enough iron to make the hoppers. So I made it with 8 that go across, and then of course the hopper chain down. I don't want to go up on it. Down, I want to go up. So I just will drop these in here. They will find their way into the right chest down in my sorter, and when I'm ready to start my project, I'll just run down there and get what I need. So do I have enough levels? Do I have enough tools? I do need some torches. That's not very many. But it'll do. Let's see if I can take some wood downstairs. This was full of cobblestone, but now that we've got the sorter, I'm throwing it in this chest. It's making its way down. Next time I come up, I'll bring some more cobble, because we've got a couple of big building projects that we're getting ready to do. See, I've just got to grab that iron. It's really nerving me. Look a little. Nope. Okay. Yeah, I might have mentioned I am an anal retentive Virgo. So some of these areas that we're walking past, like right here, this really bothers me. It's been bothering me for a while. I have filled some of it in. When I come down here, I rarely have cobblestone because I'm headed down, not up, right? And so I don't have any cobblestone to fill this in. But I do want to fill it in, so let's do this. I have some today. Okay. A little bit more. Yep, see them out. Okay, next time I come down and I have a little bit more, I'll fill some more in. Now, I mentioned I wanted a gold XP farm, which means I need a lot of obsidian. So when I encounter lava, I'm converting it to obsidian and mining it out. Since Mahjong changed the mechanics, and you can no longer build an obsidian generator, and you know, an unlimited, well, as long as you have redstone, you have unlimited obsidian. Since that's no longer an option, I'm mining it where I find it. Okay, so where was I? Is it this one? See, we encountered lava at the end of that one. That's a cavern. And since I'm hearing a lot of mobs right in through here, I'm going to go explore this a little bit. Okay. Now I know... Yeah, that's a couple of different caverns. I'm going to block this off so that they don't fall down in on me. I'm also going to block this off. Again, I really like to work in peace. Now, don't get me wrong. I, you know, got good armor, got a good sword. I can fight the mobs until we get the zombie apocalypse. Good grief. Who can fight that? You know, you get 30 or 40 of them and they're trying to eat your face off. It's, you can be in trouble. But, you know, why mess with them if you don't have to? That's my philosophy. See, then you do something stupid like that. Come on, Geeky, work with me. See, doesn't he sound like he's right here? I think I'm real near a cavern. I mentioned before I'm running a texture pack called Chroma Hills, and I really like what they've done with the different ores. You know, I guess I'm kind of a realism kind of gal. I like it to look like what it is. Let's Let's see. And that does kind of look like it, doesn't it? Now, gold is a little bit different, but still looks like gold. Okay, let's keep going. I have found a couple of good-sized caverns. What I have not found in this world is an abandoned mine, and I'm kind of disappointed. I was really hoping to be able to create a mob farm, an XP farm, that would allow me to, you know, flow them all to one area and hold them there while I'm AFK and let me go whale on them. As a matter of fact, you know, in my last world, that was I was fortunate to find a zombie spawner pretty near my base. I was able to build an XP farm that, oh my gosh, you know, I'd park myself in that safe room, and I'd walk away for, I don't know, an hour, go make dinner, feed my mom, watch a little TV, something like that, and come back, and there'd be 400 or 500 zombies in there that had taken enough fall damage that they were a one hit. I could go in there and punch them, and they'd be dead, and I'd get all that XP. Very first time I used it, I was away from the keyboard about an hour, and I came in at, I think I was a level, I want to say 20, 21, something like that. I didn't have much. I had done some enchanting. So I'd used up all the levels. I was down to, you know, actually I think it was lower than that. I think it was like a 7. And came in after being AFK for about an hour and started wailing on those zombies. When I got done, I had 52 levels. I know, right? It was great. So anytime I need to enchant something, I go in there, park myself, do a little AFK for an hour or two, come back out, and wail on them, and jack my levels up. So, you know, I've kind of gotten spoiled, and now to go get enough levels to enchant a pick, you know, you got to mine for several hours. I don't know how people do it without XP farms. Where are we at? 408. I want to go down to, actually, I think the one down below, I probably need to go check it. I think the one down below goes to, I don't remember. I'm gonna have to check. Oh, that pick is almost done. Yeah, let's save that. Dang it, I don't have enough to go enchant this pick. Can I put the two of these together? Maybe. Well, okay. Yeah, I sure miss that efficiency. All right, let's go see what we can get. You know, even an unbreaking one would help. An efficiency one would help. I need to offload all this material anyway. I hear you. Start this smelting. Where are you? One thing I do want to do is get an anvil down here. Do I have enough iron upstairs to make one? I think I do. I used quite a bit of iron in the sorter room. I'm still recovering from that. Okay, let's see. Efficiency 4, efficiency 3. I need 3 more levels. Alright, dadgummit. Where are you? Let's just deal with you first. I know you're up here somewhere. I hear you. Now this is the area, the center part right here, where I hear a lot of mobs a lot of times. And we've got a couple of caverns around here. I think there's one on the back side of that. And then down here, there's quite a few. I think that leads to a cavern, and it's not blocked off, so. Okay, oh, come on, really? I don't have any more. Of course not. Here, dirt will work. Okay. Waiting on my Waiting on my efficiency 5 pick. My next pick to be efficiency 5 to go finish that obsidian. I have pulled. Let's see. 9 stacks of 64. Plus 4 more stacks of 64 down in the sorter room, so 13 stacks of obsidian out of this mine down here. And it's still not quite enough to make my XP farm, my gold farm. Now I want it to do both things. I want it to give me gold, and you know when you get those gold nuggets, you can put them together to make gold ingots. But I also want to flow them down to a capture area where I can whale on them and they can't hit me, and I get some XP. That is my goal. Okay, this is a big cavern, as you can see over here. It goes back quite a ways that way. I've got it blocked off because, again, you know, I'm not a big one for caving. I don't necessarily want to explore that. There's too many places for them to kill me. Too many places for them to wail on me, you know, sneak up on me. Creepers especially. Creepers have killed me more times than I can count. Now, I am wearing pretty good armor right now, but it's, you know, it's never good enough. It gets right up on you. You're toast. You're history. Twenty-seven levels. Just not enough. Okay, well, mining obsidian doesn't give you any levels. I do want to check the number of levels that I, or the number of blocks back that this front end of the mine goes, because I want to connect them on both ends. So let me just go get a quick block reading and then we'll keep mining. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, this one goes all the way back. I've got some lava right around here. Now, I do occasionally poke these little side holes through, you know, to test am I hitting the mine shaft beside me, and if it's a good place, I'll go ahead and cut a channel so I can move across. Sometimes though, I just do one that Oh, here's one. It just looks like this. It's just enough to flow through. Here we go. I had a whole bunch of stuff there, had mined it all out, so I decided to just leave it. You see this torch on the back wall? This is telling me that this is our two wide channel. So this block, we are at 567. 567, yep. So I'd go up two as well and hit this. So I want this, both ends, you to be able to freely move between both the upper and lower mines. I'll put a few in here just so I can find them. Now upstairs, two up, and then that's the third one. So that would actually be where, oh, good grief, where it would pop out, that one right there. So just wanna, like I said, two wide means this is the back end of the mine. Torches on the left means that's the direction back towards the mine. As you can see, I'm right down here on bedrock. What was this? Oh yeah, cavern. Again, I don't like them to be able to drop in on me, so put that in. Do I have any ladders with me? No, but I have enough to make ladders. Okay, you know what? Let's put together a crafting table. Heck, I'll also do a couple of furnaces back here. Why not, right? Four ought to do it. Yeah, I like being organized. I like having this stuff pretty much everywhere. Put a small chest in there, but for right now, let's just make what we need. Okay, 27 ladders ought to get us up there and back, right? Let's go ahead and do this down. Want it wide. Okay, so right here, we'll put some ladders up. On one side, then we're going to get a walk across. Okay, two. Let's see. Oh, good grief. Mean ladders, not always the greatest of friends. Let's see. Is that, there we go. There we go. Okay, two wide. We're gonna make a little ledge here. Do our three up. Look at, what is this? Uh-oh. Oh yeah, I really hate caving. I think I mentioned that. We got creepers. God, we got a lot of resources in here. Okay, well. Dark. Oh, you know what? I forgot to mark where I came in. Oh, this could be not cool. Is it this way? Right? Oh yeah, okay. So... I like to point to where I'm going. It's easy enough to find my way back when I'm, you know, right at the beginning, but man, that could go south in a hurry. I've gotten lost in a cave and wound up having to dig myself out. Just dig straight up. I spent like 2 hours running around in the cave trying to find out. Oh, now this is dangerous. Was it this way? Same as before. Oh, that does not sound good. I hate the little ones. Man, they are so fast. I'm hoping he's not in this chamber with me. That could be bad. Good grief, right? Oh my goodness. Let's get a little distance down here. God, I hate to leave all this iron behind. I just do. Alright, come on, big boy. Come on. Yeah, I've been killed one too many times by zombies. By the zombie apocalypse. I'm a little skittish. What can I tell ya? Okay. Just give me enough to enchant something. Come on! You know, I've done some math. It takes a substantial amount of XP to get from level 0 to 15, right? But it takes 4 times that much to get from level 15 to level 20. And then it takes, I don't know, 3 times that much, whatever that new number is, to get from 20 to 25. It goes up exponentially. Each one of these little green hatches represents, you know, in the beginning, 3 XP balls. From 0 to 15, it's 3 balls for each hatch. But from 16 and up, it's 6 balls. And then 16 and 17, or 17, it's more than that. You know, I mean, it just keeps adding a factor of 3. Oh, tell me this is out. See, I've done it. I've gotten myself lost. Oh, good grief. Is it this way? No, this was in, so keep the torches on the left. Here we go. And here's out. Okay, so what I'm going to do for right now, I'm just going to block this off. Yep, that's all kinds of fun resources there when I need it. I'm going to go over here where it's safe mining. I just need 2 more levels. Get this set up, the initial setup. I do like things being nice and tidy. What can I tell you? I think I mentioned to you before, anal retentive, Virgo. Yep. OCD. Call it whatever you want. My mines are typically nice and neat. Okay, so we're all gonna go one back. This is going to be the upper. Oh yeah. He called his friends. Here they come. Oh. Takes a lot of work to have a nice, neat mine, but in my opinion, it's worth it. Okay, so this represents the next slit. Ditto here. Ditto here. And is this right here, okay? So I like to get them started and lit up. I put the torches on the second block in. Why? Because I like to block it off here and here with cobblestone, remember? See, look at that XP right there. Just calling my name. Okay, well, I'm going to take, this is the one we came out, right? I'm just going to take this one back to the front of the mine. And hopefully by then I'll have enough XP. No. Really? Okay. Come on. Okay, so this is headed back towards the front of the mine, so all the torches will now be on the left, indicating we're headed towards home base. Okay, having technical difficulties. I will be right back. Okay, sorry about that. I am my mother's caregiver. She's had some health issues, and I monitor her on camera here, so I know if she's needs something, and she had momentarily disappeared off camera, so I was getting a little worried. I'm pulling a lot of fun stuff out, but where's my XP? I am also hearing some lava, so I will slow down and do things safely. So I will not stand underneath it. I'll do two in and one down. So anything else that I do will give it a channel to flow and it won't hit me. Two in, one down. Oop. Okay, maybe not. Two in, one down. And do the rest. What is that? Looks like another cavern, doesn't it? Isn't that interesting? I don't know what that's about. Oh, emerald? Nice. Must be getting close to a cavern. Nice. Do I have... Oh, I don't have my Fortune 3 back with me. Okay, well. I wonder if I should just go around them. And then come back with my Efficiency 3 pick. Thank you. think I'm just gonna go for it. I do just want to make sure there's no lava about to drop in on me. Or water. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, come on! Good grief. Oh, again. Good grief. Water flowing. I'm normally a better shot than this, just saying. Okay. Oh my goodness. Okay, we're gonna pull these diamonds out of here before anything else happens. Well, this was a nice little pocket. Why aren't they picking up? Okay, well. Okay, what, well, do I have chests at the other end? I do not. Oh my goodness. May need to kind of crouch through here. I tell you what, I'm headed back. I've got a full inventory. I can't really do anything about that until I head downstairs. Keep the torches on the left. We're headed in the right direction. Bring enough wood down there to make chests and stuff on the other end. Okay. Diamonds, emeralds. Nice, pretty good little catch. Let's put gold. Iron. That did not sound fun for the poor bat. Okay. Tell you what, let's condense this into blocks. Takes up less space that way. And we'll carry that up. We will put the wood. Oh, I said I... Here, we'll take this over there. See, I really don't have another pick I can use for that. Oh, 29. I'm so close. Give me enough to. Tell you what, this was a pretty good little run. And I only ran like 1.5 slit. Not even all of that. Now see, this right here would be the reason not to put an industrial furnace in that has auto hoppers that feeds the fuel and that kind of thing, because you get experience points when you pull the things that you smelt out. And if you do the auto smelting, the industrial smelting, you don't get those experience points, you lose those. So this would be a reason to not do that. That's my reason anyway. Okay, see, I got I'm a third of the way through 29 just from my smelting. Okay, so I believe it was this one, right? No. I think this is the one that came out where the diamonds were. Okay, away from the mine. Torches on the right. My cobble. Do like my cobble to be there. Oh, I see it now. I couldn't figure out what that noise was. I was hitting this dirt. Now I know some people like to clear the dirt, especially when they're cutting a slit like this, because dirt can often hide, some handy dandy resources. But I just find that I get, an efficient use of my time to just go straight down. I only go sideways when there is something worth going sideways for. And while dirt may hide it, the chances of there being a large enough vein to be worth going after are pretty slim, because my slits are 2 blocks apart. So I just try to stay focused on the slit that I'm cutting. I go sideways if there's an ore worth going after. Redstone, coal, something like that. Here we go. And I don't have to jump up in there to get the coal out. All I have to do is bring the blocks out, and it'll bring the coal to me. In fact, that's the premise behind the item elevator that uses, you know, glass blocks and like that to pull them out. It's just one of the mechanics of the game. When there's a solid block that's between it and the next air block, it'll jump. So let's see, am I going away from the front of the mine? I am. Spooky noise. Okay. 30. So wait. Okay, we're there. We have enough to enchant a stupid pick. I just hope it's a good enchant. So I won't have a whole bunch of levels to waste. I really need to do like 33, frankly. I need two picks. I'm almost out of this one. The other two are dead. If I can get a good enchant, like an efficiency 4, I can marry it with the other efficiency 4 I have and get an efficiency 5. That would stinking be awesome. However, I hear lava. Yes, I do. So, all right. Okay, so let's see what we have here. Turn this to obsidian. If I have a, and it looks like I do. It doesn't go under there. One of the things I'm doing is I'm looking for this edge. I'm making sure that it doesn't flow under this wall, like right here. Right there, see, it's all the way around, which means I'm gonna get a really good obsidian pool right here. So I'll drop this water. Nice. Drop it here. Now this is the way I work. I like to bore down right beside it to make sure there's not lava right beside it. So I like to edge it, is what I call it. Make sure. And that's gonna let me just cut right down. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Now for right this minute, I'll edge it and then go over it. Keep cutting my slit because I'm looking for points, right? But this is going to be a good block of obsidian for my XP farm. And it looks like it was a very shallow pool. That's good news for us. That means I can just get started. Oh, that's stupid. There we go. Okay. Okay, yep. Good, there's not, unless there's, you know, something deep right in the center, the chances are pretty good there's not going to be any surprises in here, which allows me to come in here with an efficiency 5 pick and really whale on it. Oh, made a liar out of me. Okay, so we did have some deeper stuff in there, so I'm going to put a torch on that to let myself know. That's just kind of my signal for lava, is a torch on cobble. Let's see how much this will take away from my pick. Yeah, I really need a lot of levels. I need to enchant some diamond armor. Right now I'm wearing iron, I think. Am I wearing iron? Let's take a look as soon as I mine this block. Ooh, that was close. So yeah, I am wearing iron. It is enchanted, but it is iron. And as you can see, I've got a number of light enchants right in here, but it, you know, it's breaking down. Let's see. Mining obsidian has to be one of the most boring things there is to do. Oh, that was so close. Oh my god, I thought I was falling in the lava. Nope, not that way. That's good news. It is kind of a shallow pool. I mean, there are a couple in the middle that are deeper, but I'm able to hit the block below it and bring that cobblestone forward. So that's always good news. I've worked on obsidian pools that were 3 and 4 blocks deep. I mean, you want to talk about work. Okay. Like I said, boring. So what should we talk about? Should we talk about the weather in Arizona? Because it's pretty nice. Should we talk about my grandchildren? That's always fun. For me, anyway. I don't know about you guys. Yep, that's right. I'm a Minecraft playing grandmother. 3 grandchildren. Ages 11, 9, and 3. And pretty much the light of my life. I started Minecraft to help them. Wanted to be able to teach them stuff, wanted to be able to play with them. I have a PS3 and they do too. So by getting, when we both got Minecraft, we're able to play. You know, I'm in my house, they're in their house. So as long as mom says it's okay for them to stay up, they get to play with Grandma Nay, which is pretty cool. Makes me pretty happy. Raven, the oldest, is 11. And, oh, so smart. In robotics, on the computer, really crafty. I mean, she just has a lot going for her. I guess you could tell I'm a little proud. Okay, well, I hear more lava, which means it's probably right under there. Okay. Gotta be careful here now. I think we're over the biggest part of it. The depth of the pool, I mean. See, that spooky noise again. Is that three times since we've been down here? So we've done three Minecraft days, three Minecraft nights, right? Tell you what, let's do these last two obsidian. Then we'll head upstairs, we'll offload everything. And I want to go check my iron golem farm, because this is the first session where I've got it working. I had a problem. I had spent some time resolving it. Let me just make sure I got all those. I did. Okay. So this is the first time it's working uninterrupted and you know, without being babysat. So I'm curious how much iron has been produced while I've been down here mining. So I want to compare. Yep, that's a creeper. Do I really want to leave him running around up here? No. So let's go hit him for who. There are two of them. How did he get in? Is it dark enough? Okay, I don't know. Don't know how I got in. Ouch. Okay, so there's five. Okay, so while we've been down here working, five. Oh, I had some of this down here. I don't know how much. So, okay, we'll call it a stack and a half, right? Pull these upstairs. Do I have any room for anything else? That's all I got room for. Okay, so a stack and a half of iron while I've been mining. Now I'm also getting XP, which is definitely a perk, but let's go see how much the Iron Golem farm has produced in the same time period. Okay, it's dark. Let's sleep, put our stuff up, and go take a look. Okay, so drop the cobble. Block of coal. I have a personal stash going over here. I'm gonna put that over here for now. Emeralds. I have obsidian, I think, going over here. Yep. Gunpowder we can put down here. Gold down here. Redstone. Okay, dang it, I forgot to put that that dark oak off. Where is he? Oh, really? Gonna open my door? Come on. Okay, so let's go take a look at the chickens, because you saw me check that before I came in here. We left just the stripes across there, took all the other chickens. So 23 chickens, 23 feathers. I'm hoping for a stack of iron. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, fingers crossed. 43. Well, that's not a stack, but it's not anything to sneeze at either. So while I'm downstairs mining, my iron golem farm is up here producing iron as well. So. Okay, well, that was interesting. Here's what you missed in the technical difficulties. So I went back over, I died, I was doing another stream, I went over to the mob farm, I died again, lost a bunch of levels, gained some back, came back out to check my farm, and have some more iron. Now, that's all well and fine, but I am still having technical difficulties, so I apologize. My goal was to wrap things up, so I've come back in pretty much just to say good evening. Put the deal in the background here. So this is the Geeky Minecrafter ending her first, quote, stream that spanned a couple of days, so my apologies. Check back in. I will try to stream a little bit more often. I am interested in your feedback on what you'd like to see on the channel and what works for you. So take a moment, let me know down below, comment on the videos, reach out on Google+ or Twitter. Love to hear from you. Till the next time, this is the Geeky Minecrafter signing out. Happy mining!